Ah, this bird is so proud. It's a hero. It has some food. It is being a hero to its spouse. But we are not here to be heroes to one another. Men to women to men, women to women. We must shed the role of being heroes to one another and instead focus on the Holy Spirit's training program, which frees us from the continuity issue. We are not problem solvers. We were not created to be problem solvers. We cannot solve the continuity issue. Only the Holy Spirit can. What we do is we flee from it. We deny it and we flee from it. That is not problem solving. So let us not be like the birds. Do we really know what anything is? Do we know what impermanence is? Can impermanence be known? Do we know anything at all about impermanence? We say this thing, this impermanent thing, this thing of impermanence. But what is that? Is this really a flower? We call it a flower, we name it a flower, but do we really know what it is? Or do we only know our definition? It's better to say that we don't really know what anything is. 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 The old orange tree. We're about the same age, this orange tree and I. And we've both seen better days. And we try to keep each other going. But it's not easy, but we're doing okay. But one thing we don't like are these suckers right here. These suckers pull the energy out of the tree and don't bear any fruit at all. They grow very fast and seem wonderful, but they never give any oranges. So what we need to do is we need to pull those suckers off of there, like this. And say, not now, not now, not now. Too late, too late, too late. Definition is perception. Perception is definition. We try to expand our perception through tools like this camera. But it's all just still definitions. Perception equal definitions. Now, since we are so used to definitions, we don't want to drop definitions. We feel there'll be a continuity problem if we do that. The Holy Spirit solves this continuity problem by giving us new definitions. These new definitions cannot be perceived. They can only be seen. And why is that? So as not to impinge or attack our perceptions, but rather to give us another option that we can choose. So let us choose to see the Holy Spirit's redefinition overlaying perception. The spiritual path is difficult, isn't it? We have a hard time accepting that the continuity problem has been solved. Our efforts are like this little plant here, trying to find some way to grow in wisdom here.
And sometimes it gets really out of focus for us. And things go really dark. But when we keep our efforts going, we can somehow manage to get it back in focus. Remember, underneath these stones is infinite earth. The roots can reach it. Your roots can reach the soil of the Holy Spirit.
Our life is slowly slipping away, a day at a time. And we can begin to read the writing on the wall, can't we? We need to realize, we need to redefine, we need the continuity problem solved, we need the Holy Spirit. Because the days of our lives are quickly passing. The world seems very chaotic, doesn't it? And sometimes that chaos grows stronger. And we really don't know what to do. Have a problem. Can we not just scale it back a little bit? Bit by bit by bit. Bit by bit by bit. Bit by bit by bit. Can we not take the path towards wisdom? Bit by bit by bit. Listen to the Holy Spirit. Bit by bit by bit by bit. We scale it back like that. In our lives. Do we really know where anything stops and something else starts? Is there a true ending at all? Our lives go by just like this, so fleeting, like little bugs. But behind this, we see something, as it were, etched into our memory. Something reminding us of permanence, a definition of permanence. We can pay attention to this definition of permanence instead of the fleeting and impermanent. The information age. We're getting a lot of something. But what is it really that we're getting? Are we getting it? Or just IT? Are we getting the Holy Spirit's resolution of the continuity problem? No? Then what are we getting? Maybe a whole lot of nothing. A whole lot of nothing moving real fast. And that is not it.
Behind all our defenses is the definition of eternal life, which is the intermediate step back to dropping all definitions. Now we can bring this into focus, and as we do, the fence gets a little out of focus. It's still there, but we're not looking at it so distinctly. Our attention is what is beyond our defenses. The definitions of the Holy Spirit. Definitions that are not being redefined. Definitions that solve the continuity problem for us. Our attention is placed on that, and we don't need to pay much attention to all the nonsense that we've been through. See right past it like this. We have so many distractions that act as a veil to even considering what may lie beyond our defenses. And at times, it becomes totally overwhelming. And we need to dial it back a little bit. Now, if we get it dialed back a little bit, it's not quite as bad. Let's see if we can dial it back a little more. That's a little better. There, now we're talking. You see? Much, much better. We can do that. Right now, it may look like this. Really troublesome, huh? But we can dial it back like that. And even so, we're hardly bothered by it at all, and we can see past all the chaos here to the flower of eternal life. The strings of perception are not clear at all. And they're leading us to a very uncertain and fuzzy future. We need to throw a little bit of clarity on the situation. And find out where we're going. And we might be headed into a big old jungle, huh? And things will get really cloudy there. Really unclear. We'll be lost in the big thicket. Don't trust the senses. Don't trust perception. Don't trust the flesh and where the flesh tells you to go. Don't trust it. There's something inside, if we can just see it, if we can just get focused on it, if we can just get enough light, there is something inside that will save us from sensory perception. So, by all means, we must refresh ourselves and taste the difference. Refresh yourself. and taste the difference. Refresh yourself and taste the difference. Holy Spirit.
Having trouble? There is a remedy.
The Holy Spirit is the answer because it solves a continuity problem. So, refresh yourself and taste the difference. The difference between the ego and the Holy Spirit.
Refresh yourself and taste the difference.
The ego's plan doesn't work. The Holy Spirit's plan does work. So, refresh yourself and taste the difference. The Holy Spirit solves the continuity problem. So refresh yourself and taste the difference. Refresh yourself and taste the difference. Refresh yourself. We have a hard time figuring anything out here in this world, don't we? But if we just make a little adjustment here, we see, now we don't have so much of a problem. So instead of looking down here, look up here, and it all becomes clear. And then eventually we look up here, and it all becomes more beautiful. And we head off beyond definitions. Beyond what we can imagine.
All we need is a little bit of clarity. But things keep intervening, don't they? Causing all sorts of problems. Just when we think we have it, something arises and messes it all up. And distracts us. The background is dancing in all sorts of different directions. Telling us, pay attention to this, pay attention to this. And it knocks our clarity out, doesn't it? It knocks it this way and that way. And it seems to be gone. But we can put it back. Better than ever. And we will do that. And what brings the clarity? The Holy Spirit brings the clarity. Our situation can lighten up. Just like that. And it can also go in that direction too. But what we want is it to go this way. What can bring us that way? And what can help us avoid this direction? This is the direction the world is going in right now. If we put the world in this situation right about here, we can say that it is going this way. All right, so instead of that way, what we want it to go is we want it to go like this, lighten up. But we don't have to go to the light too quickly. We can enjoy the ambience of the Holy Spirit's redefinition and the beauty of it and gradually we will finally transcend all definitions. A cosmic dance. Constantly moving about. Ebbing and flowing like tides. Can we not rise above this? Yes, we can. Are we lost in a masquerade? Does going around and around and around and around and around really prove anything? Does it really mean anything? What does it mean, going around and around? Doesn't really mean anything, does it? We're in the time right now where everything is tending to sort itself out. The wheat from the chaff. And we are simply in that process right now of those who want to go with the Holy Spirit's training program and those who decide that they don't want to. They want to stay, keep doubling down with the ego. We just have to let that sort itself out. And finally, we get this. Parting of the ways. Parting of the destiny paths. Right now, everything seems to be very homogenized, doesn't it? Like this. But really, there's a lot of activity going on. Tremendous activity within. And over a period of time, there's an enormous sorting out taking place. And when we see this, we need to realize that yes, it is taking place. And we don't want to be stuck in darkness, do we? Be like the cream and rise to the top. Beneath it's a darkness, another layer of complexity on top of that, and on top is the pure clarity. The clarity is there. Beyond perception, beyond definitions of the ego, are the definitions of the Holy Spirit. And there's no redefinition there, just clarity. We must get out of the darkness and go towards the light. We went from the light into this crazy idea, and we were trapped down, down, down we went into the darkest depths of confusion, where everything was upside down and backwards, and now we need to go up from this confusion, back up from our entrapment and definitions. Up towards the light. Higher and higher and higher we go. Out of that crazy bottle that we've been in. And back into the light. How strange it has all been, this flowing of blood through our corpuscles. Life after life after life. Where is it all going? And for what? And does it really matter? Does it matter to life? The arcane complexities of fantasy, delusion, belief, make-believe, imagination, plausibility. Will it ever sort itself out? Certainly not without the help of the Holy Spirit. Everything will just keep on flowing about. Leverage. The Holy Spirit has leverage. No matter how mixed up we believe ourselves to be, the incredible leverage of the Holy Spirit is able to collapse time for us. Confusion seems to be overwhelming at times, doesn't it? But just watch the leverage of the Holy Spirit go to work here. we think, no way can we find our way back to clarity, to oneness, away from all this definition, this tale of death. But watch what happens here. Leverage, leverage, leverage. And clarity is quickly returning. Most of the process has been completed. Just little tiny bits are still falling back. That's the leverage of the Holy Spirit for you. We'll complete a seemingly impossible assignment in the briefest of times. Simple process, simple leverage. Doesn't take long. Everything settling back into place easily. No problem, no effort, no strain. Continuity problem resolved. So it seems that the situation is just too doggone difficult. And we're struggling with this very, very terrible situation now. How does it all get rearranged? How do we get free of this? It's pretty difficult to explain, isn't it? And yet, there is a way. There is a way. Beautiful, huh? Beautiful. Holy Spirit resolves the continuity problem for us. We don't have to do anything. Just accept it. Enjoy the resolution. The moon is on the move. As you can plainly see. Time doesn't wait for anyone or anything, but the Holy Spirit collapses time. Background music by the Crickets.